morning, everybody. My name is Christopher. My topic is, should we be scared of the police? And it's basically about police violence and what's been happening recently. Cops are scary, and just because they don't show emotion doesn't mean they want to hurt you. And without cops, nobody is safe. And not all cops are out to get you, as seen in this picture. Cops go to the movies and have fun just like everybody else. If you drive, you know how scary cops can be. They're trained to be manipulative and to make you say stuff to get yourself in trouble. Credibility. I've been pulled over when I lived in New Mexico over the summer, and it was a state trooper, so he's even worse than a cop. I didn't have my driver's license, and he was really cool about it, and he let me off with a warning instead of a ticket. And I asked him a lot of stuff, and not all of them are out to put you in jail or to arrest you, to give you tickets to meet their quota. They're just like everybody else. Behind their badge, they have a heart, they bleed like everybody else, and they have emotions and families. And they sacrifice their lives to protect us, and although they aren't out to get us, people still want to hurt cops because of the things they do to their, if they're in a gang, they do to their friends. And therefore, everybody that isn't law enforcement is a threat to law enforcement. My thesis is about law enforcement and how they are supposed to protect us. So why do they always kill innocent people? Law enforcement put their lives on the line to protect us and prevent everyday encounters that are not good. And then cops are trained to use lethal force when needed, but just because they use lethal force doesn't mean all cops use it in a good way. Most of them use it in a bad way. First, I will go over why cops use the force they do and why they need to arm themselves with weapons. And then secondly, I will go over why they're so stoic and why they don't show emotion. And then lastly, I will argue why police should not be feared, but in a sense, revered. Main point one, I will go over why police use force to use and why they need to arm themselves with weapons. Resistance is the first reason that officers usually feel forced to use their arms, knees, and elbows. Police are trained to use deadly force with their anything on their body, including their batons. In an article online called Police One, the author says, it might be a surprise to some people to discover that when a suspect strikes an officer, or even acts as if he or she is about to strike an officer, that an officer can legally deliver impacts that with what we call personal body weapons. Just because police officers are the law doesn't mean that people don't want to hurt them. They're only human. Cops want to see your hands at all times when you get pulled over. If your hands are anywhere, say even if you're innocent, just getting pulled over for a broken taillight and you reach into your glove compartment, cops will come up with a gun because they don't know what you're reaching for. Remaining calm and cooperating are the best things you could do. In an article by NBC, the author states, do not curse or raise your voice, try to stay calm. And remember, confrontation leads to confrontation, which is basically saying, if you move, the cop will move, and if you do something the cop sees that could be, fearful for his life, he can legally shoot you, tase you, pepper spray you, take you out of the car, arrest you, and hurt you. Now I've told you why police use the force they use, as well as why people take precautions and are always ready for everything. Now I'll tell you why police are so stoic and show no emotions. In an article by the Washington Post, the author writes, you don't know what is in my mind when I stop you. Did I just get a radio call with shooting moments ago? Am I looking for a murderer or an armed fugitive? For you, this might be a simple traffic stop. But for me, each traffic stop is potentially a dangerous encounter. Show me some empathy for officers' safety concerns. Don't make our job more difficult than it already is. Officers see crazy things every day, especially here in LA. We're not a very calm town. Like, there's strikes that go on. Say if somebody gets killed in like a town, and then we have a majority of Black, Latino, and white communities. If somebody gets killed that's black, the community will unite together and they will fight to defend their rights and make it aware that police are hurting people they shouldn't be. And then police run the risk of being shot, hit by a car, or getting assaulted. And police treat every traffic stop differently. No matter who you are, it's a very serious matter. Police contain their emotions to suppress yours. Not all cops are mean, but they need to suppress their own emotions to suppress yours as well. Because if a cop comes up to you and he's happy and he says, "Oh, good day, how are you?" and then say you're in a gang, and the cop goes back to his car and he takes your information, and you drive away, the cop essentially made it easier for you to drive away because he's making himself look soft. In an article by The Badge Guys, the author states, "Police emotions being kept in check from public serves both as a shield to protect themselves and to present a controlled professional presence and to help calm highly charged individuals when they are dealing with a call." People will take the cop serious when he is stern with what he says and does what he says. Cops don't get emotionally involved with anybody except their families because it gets in the way of their job. For my last argument, I will go over why police should not be feared. Not every cop is trained to hurt, kill, and injure somebody. Cops treat us the way they do because they know people hate cops, and cops can't tell how people are going to feel towards them. In an article, by Conspiracy Watch, the author disagrees with law enforcement and the power they abuse and says, "The American police perform no positive function. They pose much larger threat to citizens than do the criminals who operate without a police badge. Americans would be safer if the police forces were abolished." If police forces were abolished, there would be no order and nothing would be good. Everybody would be fending for themselves, say like for a Purge movie. There would be no laws, no basis. There would be nothing to control anything like riots or killings and stuff. And then police abuse their power because some police see things that they don't see, that everybody else doesn't see, right? Conclusion, cops use the force they do because lethal force because nobody knows what a criminal looks like, and for that matter, what anybody looks like wants to harm a police officer. First, I went over why cops use the force they do. Then I explained why police are so stoic and don't show emotion. And finally, I explained why police should not be feared. Police officers protect us and don't think they want to kill us. They use their powers to prevent crimes from happening and not to intimidate us. The next time you see a police officer, thank him because one day he could just save your life. Thank you.